The law of attraction shows us that our experience of reality is a direct reflection and manifestation of how we view ourselves and the world. And we each have different ways of perceiving ourselves and what we are capable of creating. It is that perception that forms the self-image, or what might also be called the self-identity. As you learned in my last video, our brain will always reaffirm who we think and believe we are by sifting through the millions of bits of information it receives each day and presenting us with only the pieces that it deems to be a match to that identity. Because of the way the brain works, the identity becomes dependent on outer experiences unless given instructions to do otherwise. We become addicted, in a sense, to the outer cues to reinforce the emotional state. And this creates a loop that reinforces itself and recreates the same things over and over again. But when we remove our focus from the outer experiences, we can begin to create a new internal experience as a roadmap for our brain to take us to a new destination. From this vantage point, we can recreate the self-image or self-identity and then allow our brain to seek out information and experiences that reaffirm that as our experience of reality. Our brain does this all day long anyway, so why not give it the cues of your choosing so you can experience and manifest the reality you prefer? The following process will show you how to enter a cheat code, so to speak, into the information bank of your brain that will allow it to go to work for you and your manifestation goals. Following are 6 steps that will show you how to do this. Number 1. The first thing to note is that the self-image is created via experience, not willpower. You can't just tell it what you want and will it to happen. So the brain must be given a new sensory-rich experience to work with in order to make this change. And that experience must be recreated over and over again until the brain accepts it as something that has actually already happened. This is accomplished through mental rehearsal. Essentially, through your mental rehearsal, you are giving it a new goal to strive for and reaffirm as your reality. And because the brain is a goal-oriented machine, it will do just that once the goal has been given to it successfully. Note that the brain does not make a determination as to whether something is negative or positive for you. It simply strives for the goal you give it to strive for via your thoughts, beliefs, and self-identity. Number 2. Choose your goal so that you can write out a detailed script of what you are manifesting. Try to choose a specific goal rather than something too general. The subconscious mind has a difficult time understanding a general goal like happiness, because happiness can include many aspects of your life. So what does happiness actually mean to you? What does it look like? And how does it feel? Is it financial prosperity? A dynamic relationship? A heightened spiritual connection? A better career? Or maybe it's all of these things combined. Really hone in on the goal that you are going to give your brain to work with. The subconscious mind needs clear details of what you truly want in order to seek out the manifestation of that goal. Because the subconscious takes things literally, it will stop seeking out your manifestation goal as soon as it thinks it has satisfied the criteria that you've given it. Therefore, if the criteria are too general, the manifested results can be disappointing, because the subconscious mind won't know what resources to mobilize in order to accomplish the full goal. Number 3. To begin writing your script, use the following questions as a guideline to assist you with these details. What will I see in my life that will let me know that I have achieved this goal? More specifically, when I manifest this goal, what will I see in my life that I don't see now? What will I hear other people saying about me when I have manifested this goal? What will I say about myself when I manifest this goal? Number 4. In order to speak the language of the subconscious mind, rather than a foreign language that it doesn't understand, you will need to incorporate feeling into this script and the visualization process you are going to create from this script. The main question you will need to ask yourself is this: how will you feel when you have manifested this goal? But let's don't stop there. It's important to really gain a descriptive grasp of this feeling, and the best way to accomplish this task is to imagine a time in your past when you experienced this. To do this, close your eyes for a few moments and imagine something you experienced that created this desired feeling. Allow yourself to re-experience the feeling as much as possible. Some people tell me that they have never experienced the feeling of something that they are trying to manifest, and they are unable to do this. If this applies to you, I recommend imagining you are a person who you admire who has already manifested this goal and how they feel with that experience. It's also important to remember that the part of you that has the desire for this thing can only give you that desire because it senses how it would feel to have it. You may choose to focus on that part of you as an alternative. Once you have tuned into this feeling, ask the following questions of yourself and incorporate your answers within your script. While pulling up this feeling, where in my body do I recognize the greatest concentration of it? If I were to associate a color with this feeling, what color would that be? If I were to associate a temperature with this feeling, what temperature would it be? Can I associate a shape with this feeling? What shape do I see it as? If I were to rub my hands across this feeling, what would the texture be? Although these questions may seem a little silly, this is a very powerful part of this process, and I recommend not skipping it. Oftentimes, our words are only abstractions to the subconscious mind. So breaking them down into a more sensory-based description will assist you in fully connecting with the subconscious mind in the language it speaks. Use the answers to these questions when writing your script. You can use those answers when talking about your feeling states, as well as when you're describing physical objects. Essentially, you're associating physical descriptions with your feeling states that your subconscious mind will recognize each time you use those descriptions, because they're tangible, sensory-based descriptions of an otherwise abstract concept. In other words, you're defining your desired feeling state in such a way that the subconscious mind can understand it and mobilize its resources to manifest the feeling that draws to you the matching experience. Number 5. Once you have written your script, read it over and over again. Memorize it and visualize it often. Make it a mental movie that replays over and over again in your mind, incorporating all of the information you have gathered from the previous points. Be certain that during the visualization of your script, that you are capturing the feeling states that you defined in detail, including the physical attributes of those states. Tune into that feeling intently while using your mental imagery. Make this a fixed part of your routine for about 10 to 15 minutes per day, for no less than 30 days. Number 6. When you see evidence of things that match your scripted process, begin keeping a journal of those things. No matter how big or small, write those things down. For example, if your feeling states were associated with the color green, write down something you noticed that was green throughout your day. If you see something that is associated with what you wrote down that you might see when your complete goal is manifested, write that down as well. The puzzle may not be complete just yet, but you are gathering evidence of the pieces. And in doing this, you are beginning to collect that evidence that your manifestation is in the oven and cooking to completion, so to speak. And in collecting this evidence, you are giving your brain more information to work with where this goal is concerned, and more reason to reaffirm your new self-image, your new self-identity, and your new manifestation. The law of attraction reflects back to us what we most dominantly believe about ourselves and the world around us. So clarifying your manifestation goals for the subconscious mind in a language that it can understand is critical to achieving the manifestation results that you desire. With this technique, you are in effect installing a cheat code in your brain that recreates the identity of who you are and what you experience from life, giving it a roadmap for it to follow until it arrives at your specified destination. When you expand your personal identity on a subconscious level, you expand what becomes possible for you to experience. Looking for some advanced manifestation techniques? Visit my website for step-by-step processes that guide you through your manifestation journey. There you'll find free content, a VIP membership option, meditations, mini courses, and my master course, Ultimate Manifestation Mastery, where you'll learn how to train your brain for effortless manifestation. Or subscribe to this channel for weekly manifestation tips.